Hi, judges! Welcome to another segment of One Arliwag Memorial High School Senior High School Math TV. And for today's video lesson, we will tackle about sigma notation or summation notation. So, what is sigma notation or summation notation? The most commonly used notation in statistics is the summation notation, or what we call as the sigma notation. And the symbol for summation notation or sigma notation is the Greek letter sigma, which reads the sum of or the summation of. So that is how we read this symbol, sigma. So we read it as the sum of or the summation of. So the summation notation is simply writing equations in a shorter way. So last time we were able to discuss sequence and series. So, sequences and series are much longer than the simple equations. So, in order for us to write sequences and series in a much shorter version, therefore, we will be using summation notation. Okay? So, again, summation notation is simply writing equations in a shorter way. So, what are the parts of summation notation? Okay, so we have here the symbol for summation notation. So this is the symbol, and that is sigma again. So the letter here is the stopping point or the upper limit. And for this one, we have here I, that is the index or the initial value. So I is equal to 1, therefore 1 is the starting point or the lower limit. And for this value, this is xi. Our x sub I, we call that as the element. And for the elements, we could use any letter to represent the element. Okay. So how do we read a summation notation? Okay. For this one, we will be reading it as the summation of x sub I from I is equal to 1 to n. Again, so we will be reading it as the summation of x sub I from I is equal to 1 to n, or the summation of xi from 1 to n. Okay, so let's try reading this. The summation of 3k from k is equal to 1 to 5. Is that clear? Okay, again, as I have told you earlier, you could use any letters to represent the element. Okay, so when we have summation notation, it is the shorter way of writing a formula. So, it is just like writing a formula when we are using summation notation. Okay, so what we will be doing now is to expand the summation notation. So, what do we do when we expand? So, since this is summation notation, we will be using plus. So, because when we say summation, it is sum of all the terms. So, for example, number one, we're asked to expand the summation. So, how do we read this? The summation of 3 times k from k is equal to 1 to 5. Therefore, if we will be expanding this one, since we have here from k is equal to 1 to 5, therefore, this will now be equal to 3 times 1, since this is the starting point, plus 3 times 2, plus 3 times 3, plus 3 times 4, plus 3 times 5. So we will now stop here at 5. Why? Because that is the upper limit, and that is where we stop. Okay, since this is now the expanded form, but it is not yet simplified, therefore it is equal to 3 plus 6 plus 9 plus 12 plus 15. Therefore, this is the expanded form of the summation notation. So what if you're asked to get the sum? Therefore, you just need to add. Okay, therefore, the sum would be 3 plus 6 plus 9 plus 12 plus 15. Its answer is equal to 45. Therefore, if we will now be reading this, the summation of 3k from k is equal to 1 to 5 is equal to 45. And that is the answer for this summation notation. Okay, let's have another example. For example, number 2. So, it is the summation of 2k plus 1, the quantity 2k plus 1 from... Okay, so let's say this is J. Okay. So that is now the summation of the quantity 2J plus 1 from j is equal to 0 to 5. Therefore, our initial value is 0 and our final value or our upper limit is 5. Okay, so let us now try to rewrite this one. Therefore, this becomes, let's start with 0. We will substitute the value of j or the value of this one to all the values of j. Therefore, this becomes 2 times 0 plus 1 plus 2 times 1 plus 1 plus 2 times 2 plus 1 plus 2 times 3 plus 1 plus 2 times 4 plus 1 plus 2 times 5 plus 1. Okay, so in this case, we should now simplify, and this becomes 2 times 0, that is 0 plus 1 plus 2 times 1, that is 2 plus 1, 2 times 2, that is 4 plus 1, 2 times 3, that is 6 plus 1, 2 times 4, that is 8 plus 1, 2 times 5, that is 10 plus 1. Okay, simplifying, therefore, we will now be having 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11. Therefore, this is the expanded form of this summation notation. So, if you're asked to expand, this is what you will answer. So, what is now the summation or the sum of the series? Therefore, we will just be adding 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11. Therefore, that is just equal to, very good, that is 36. Therefore, if we will be reading this, the answer would be the summation of the quantity 2j plus 1 from j is equal to 0 to 5 is equal to 36. So, that is how you answer this question. Okay, so let's now have another. For this one, we are given the summation of the quantity negative 1 raised to m minus 1 over m from 1 to 5. Okay, so let us first try to expand. Therefore, in expanding, this becomes negative 1 raised to m minus 1. Therefore, m, we will start with 1. That is 1 minus 1 over 1 plus negative 1 raised to 2 minus 1 over 2 plus negative 1 raised to 3 minus 1 over 3. Plus negative 1 raised to 4 minus 1 over 4 plus negative 1 raised to 5 minus 1 over 5. Okay, so let us now try to simplify. Therefore, this becomes negative 1 raised to 0 over 1 plus negative 1 raised to 2 minus 1, which is 1 over 2 plus negative 1 raised to 3 minus 1, that is negative 1 raised to 2 over 3 plus negative 1 raised to 4 minus 1, which is 3 over 4, plus negative 1 raised to 5 minus 1, which is 4 over 5. Okay? Therefore, the expanded form now would be, therefore, this is negative 1 raised to 0, that is just 1. 1 over 1 is 1. Okay? Plus negative 1 raised to 1, a negative number raised to an odd number. Therefore, it should be negative, okay? That is negative 1 half. Negative 1 raised to 2, even number. Therefore, it is positive. It becomes 1 third. Negative 1 raised to 3, odd. That is minus 1 over 4. Negative 1 raised to 4, even. Therefore, that becomes plus 1 over 5. And it is now the expanded form of this summation notation. Okay, so what can we say about this expanded form? Therefore, this is positive, negative, positive, negative, positive. Therefore, they have opposite signs, alternating signs. So, if they have alternating signs, always remember that if you will be writing a formula and the sequence or the series contains alternating sign, therefore, we will be using negative 1 raised to this 1, m minus 1. Is that clear? Again, we will now be using this formula to denote the signs of the series. Is that clear? So that later in our activity, let's try to use this formula if the signs of the terms in the given series would be alternating. Okay, therefore, this is now the answer for the expanded form of this summation notation. And for the fourth one, so we are given the summation of 2 raised to I plus 1 from I is equal to 0 to 5. Therefore, let us now try to expand. This becomes 2 raised to 0, 0 plus 1 plus 2 raised to 1 plus 1 plus 2 raised to 1 plus 2. That should be 2 plus 1 plus 2 raised to 3 plus 1 plus 2 raised to 4 plus 1 plus 2 raised to 5 plus 1. And this becomes now 2 raised to 0 plus 1, that is 2 raised to 1 plus 2 raised to 1 plus 1, therefore that becomes 2 raised to 2 plus 2 raised to 2 plus 1, that is 2 raised to 3 plus 2 raised to 3 plus 1, that is 2 raised to 4 plus 2 raised to 4 plus 1, 2 raised to 5. Plus 2 raised to 5 plus 1, therefore that becomes 2 raised to 6. In this case, we'll now simplify, that is equal to 2 plus 4 plus 2 times 2 times 2 is 8, 2 raised to 4 is 16, 2 raised to 5 is 32, and 2 raised to 6 is 64. And this is now the expanded form of the summation notation, the summation of 2 raised to I plus 1 from 0 to 5. Okay, so if we will be adding this, therefore the answer is 126. Okay, so we're now done expanding a summation notation. What if we are now given a series and then we're asked to write a summation notation? Okay, will the process be the same? So let us try to find out. Okay, again, what if we are given a series and we're asked to write a summation notation? We are given a much longer set of numbers and then we're asked to write it in a shorter way. And in that case, we need to write it using summation notation. Okay, so let's have here an example. Rewrite the following series in sigma notation. We have 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 plus 10 plus 12. Again, we are given 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 plus 10 plus 12. Okay, so this is how you rewrite a given series into summation notation. Step one, remember that the step one is to know if it takes the form of an arithmetic or geometric sequence. So let us try. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Is it arithmetic or geometric? Very good. It is arithmetic series. If it is arithmetic series, let us try to get first its common difference. 4 minus 2 is 2, 6 minus 4 is 2, 8 minus 6 is 2, 10 minus 8 is 2, 12 minus 10 is 2. Is that clear? Again, first step is to identify whether it is arithmetic or geometric. After identifying, all you have to do is to get the common difference or the common ratio. Since 2 is the common difference, if we will be writing a formula, write here first summation and then write the common difference, which is 2. What letter do you want to use? For example, my name is Judd, so I'll start by using J. So this becomes 2J. Okay, so in this case, if we will be starting with J is equal to 1, let us try. Let us first check. 2 times 1, therefore that is 2, right? Okay, so in that case, what if I have J is equal to 2? 2 times 2. 4. What if I have J is equal to 3? 2 times 3. 6. What if I have J is equal to 4? 2 times 4. 8. Therefore, what is now our upper limit? Therefore, this becomes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And it is now summation of 2J from J is equal to 1 to 6. And that is how we write the summation notation for this given series. Is that clear? Okay, so in this case, we now have 1 fourth plus 1 over 8 plus 1 over 16 plus 1 over 32 plus 1 over 64. Okay, since all the numerators are just 1, okay, so let's just focus on the denominator. In this case, the denominators would be 4, 8, 16, 32, 64. Is this arithmetic or geometric? So, is this arithmetic or geometric? So in this case, okay, let's say that this is 4 times 2 is 8. 8 times 2 is 16. 16 times 2 is 32. 32 times 2 is 64. Therefore, there is a common ratio. And the common ratio is 2. Since if we divide 8 by 4, that is 2. 16 divided by 8, that is 2. This is 2. This is 2. This is 2. Okay, therefore, the summation would be, let's start with the denominator. Okay, let's start with the denominator. This is 2. Okay, so what do we multiply with 2? Okay, so since the common ratio is 2, but then we could say that they are exponentially increasing, therefore there should be an exponent. Okay, since this is 2 raised to n, since we are, they are all multiplied by 2, therefore our base should be 2. Okay, for example, I have n is equal to 1, 2 raised to 1, that is 2, but not 4. Therefore, we should not start with 1. And we should start with what? What is the exponent of 2 that will result to 4? Therefore, that is 2. Very good. Therefore, this should be n is equal to 2. 2 raised to 2 is equal to 4. 2 raised to 3 is equal to 8. 2 raised to 4 is equal to 16. 2 raised to 5 is equal to 32. 2 raised to 6 is equal to 64. Therefore, what is now the upper limit? The upper limit would be 6. And the numerator will stay as 1. And therefore, this is the summation notation. Okay? I hope that this is clear. Okay, so let's have another example. For another example, I will just get another example for this one so that we could expand clearly and you will understand it better. For another example, okay, let's just have the last example first. Okay, for the last example, we are given 1/4 minus 1 over 7 plus 1 over 10 minus 1 over 13 plus 1 over 16. So how do we rewrite this as summation notation or sigma notation? Again, let us first analyze the given. For the given, we could say that it contains alternating signs, right? Okay, since this is positive, it becomes negative, positive, negative, positive. So therefore, alternating sign. And if we have alternating sign, we will be using this formula. Okay, so let's write first summation. Summation of, so the numerator is just 1, therefore let's just write here, negative 1 raised to m minus 1 over, okay, so we could use now the denominator. For the denominator, let us first identify if it is arithmetic or geometric. 7 minus 4, that is 3. 10 minus 7, that is 3. 13 minus 10, that is 3. 16 minus 13, that is 3. Therefore, the common difference is 3, and that is our common factor, 3. M. Let's say that is 3m. If that is 3m, if I will be starting with 1, 3 times 1, that is just 3. What do we add to 3 so that it becomes 4? Very good. Therefore, this should be 3m plus 1. So, what is now the initial value of m? We will start with 1. And what is the final value of m? The final value would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that is now the final value of m. So do not forget that this is m minus 1. This is m minus 1 again. So if it is m minus 1, let us try to check if it is positive. 1 minus 1 is 0. Negative 1 raised to 0 is just positive 1. Therefore, our answer is correct. So let's start with the last term. So this is 5. 5 minus 1. For checking purposes only. So this becomes negative 1 raised to 5 minus 1 over 5, 3 times 5 plus 1. Therefore, this becomes negative 1 raised to 4 over 15 plus 1. And that is negative 1 raised to an even number that becomes positive. 15 plus 1, that is 16. Is this 1 over 16? Yes. Therefore, this is now the summation notation. Okay, so I hope that this is clear. Again, a shorter way of writing a series is through summation notation. And this is the process on which we could expand a summation notation and rewrite the following series into a summation notation. Okay, so if the signs are alternating, we could use this formula, negative 1 raised to m minus 1, or any element that you would like to use. Once again, I am Engineer Judd Edward Hernandez saying that mathematics is always fun. Goodbye and God bless.